Okay, so your notebook today, you're gonna give me two different boxes, basically. What I want you to do, if you have a color, that's fine. I want you're doing a flow map of just two separate boxes. All right, there's your first box. You got to show me these notes today in your Flipgrid. All right. And first step, second step. And if you understand today, it might help you to understand what we've been doing all week. It actually may lend it to it. So right here, I'm going to put graph All right, go ahead and copy my title. All right, let me get that mouse out of the way. Graphing lines in y equals mx plus b form. Okay. So your homework today will be the video I made today was like 2 minutes long. It was not long at all, and I just showed how to do one of these graphs. All right, let's see. All right, Edgar, I'm gonna stop share right now and then I'm gonna reshare, okay? Just because Edgar said it was lagging a little bit. Right, hopefully that does better now. And there is our zoomed in version of our notes. Now take a look. I want you guys to draw the same graph in both boxes. Okay, so get caught up. I'll give you guys some time. And your task will be to graph this line. Look at my marks. I'm making them very neat, or as neat as I can. These notes will go quick. This is all we're going to do, and we're going to put a little bit of writing underneath it, just a little bit. So, what I like to do in the boxes is show you what we're doing, and underneath the box, I explain what's going on during that step. Gabriel, get your notebook out. Good morning. And if you want, Gabriel, you can do the notes later and just watch it right now, since you're a little bit behind, just to comprehend. Can you hear me? Okay. Sometimes that helps just to kind of follow along, but I will post these notes, and I'm also posting this video because right now I'm taking a video of this portion. Okay. So let me give you another second to get caught up, and then I'm gonna focus on this first box. So all I did was draw out the same graph twice and the same instructions, okay? Now, we're going to go ahead and show you what you're supposed to do. On the bottom, right here, it says, you must first plot the y-intercept on the y-axis. All right, get that written down. I'm gonna get a better color to use. My daughter keeps taking all my markers. I'm going to use colors for a reason. You know my y-intercept's negative 4. So the only thing you need to know for this one is you're going to plot this at negative 4. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4. All right? That's all I need for the first box. So your only step for this one is to just plot negative 4 here, and if you've done that, do it also over here. And we'll go to the second step. Get caught up. Okay, now I'm trying to get the best marker I can get. Get caught up. Now, for the next step, all right, it's going to be, what you're going to do now is you're going to put your pencil, your pen, on the y-intercept and either, so I should say, from y-intercept, rise to run 3, because that's your slope. And down here, I'm going to put, remember, would fall, then run. All right, and that's just for the negative slope. Okay, so here, from y-intercept, rise 2, run 3, and I should have put, and plot point. I'm gonna give you guys like 2 minutes to copy this down, and then we'll talk about it. So this is the next step. We haven't done it yet in here. I want you guys to copy this down real quick, and then we'll be done with our notes. Let's stay focused. I see you guys, let's go. Okay, so now we're going to rise and run. So I'm going to see if I can. You can see what I'm going to do. I'm going to rise one, two, run one, two, three. There's my new point. And then you could take a ruler. So basically, you plot the y-intercept first, and then from the y-intercept, you deal with the slope, okay? So people I've seen do mistakes, sometimes they'll start their slope from the origin. You don't start your slope from the origin. You start your slope from the y-intercept. If it's a rise and run, cool. If it was a negative slope, you would have fallen and ran, okay? And it would have created a negative slope. We're going to practice this the rest of the period with a Desmos. And by the end of it, I guarantee you guys will have a decent understanding, okay? I need you guys to get there so we can make sure we get this. And really, oh, our class period goes a little longer, that's right, because it's the first period. All right. Who needs more time? Raise your hand. Darwin, you need more time? Are we good? I'm gonna move on. All right, cool. So I'm gonna move on to the Desmos activity where we're just gonna practice this. So keep this next to you and just go over this. What's your first step? You do the y-intercept. What's your second step? You do the slope from the y-intercept. All right, give me a second. I'm gonna post the Desmos in your stream.